The Dream Track is a simple and intuitive pitch CV sequencer. It has four steps, and it has four individual tracks. Each track has its own clock input, clock output, and pitch CV output. In this way, it can behave like four completely independent sequencers. This way, you can send each track to a different VCO. Why would anyone want to do this? Evolving chords. For systems with two or more VCOs, you can send evolving pitch changes to droning oscillators. Polyrhythmic note progressions. There is no master clock on the Dream Track. Instead, you get to say when and how multiple sequences get their trigger timing. This can be done by your other trigger sequencers and clock dividers. Manual event triggering. You do not have to use any clock signals at all. Manually trigger pitch changes at your leisure. The Dream Track is putting out pitch CV all of the time, no matter what else is going on. Chiptune. The Dream Track uses an 8-bit microcontroller working at 20 MHz. This means it can be clocked into audio rates when you trigger it with an LFO or audio signal. A 16-pin Eurorack ribbon cable is included for connecting to your case power supply. There are two options for connecting to 5 volts. Option 1 is for systems that have 5 volts already provided. This is the default for the Dream Track, and nothing more needs to be done. However, there is option 2 for systems that do not have 5 volts provided. 5 volts power can come from the positive 12 volt line. To do so requires a Maxim integrated REF02CP 5 volt regulator sold separately. Once you get your 5 volt regulator, install the regulator chip with pin 1 in the correct position. With this little notch out here, that tells you this is pin 1, and this is one that has been correctly oriented and installed. Next, you'll have to move the shunt over one position. This little tiny thing right there. At this point, you'll be able to connect the ribbon cable to make sure that the red stripe is going to the negative 12 volt line. The connector is keyed, this little tiny key here. It's keyed so that it is connected to the Dream Track in this way and cannot be connected wrong. So this is negative 12 down here. So just pop that in, seat it down firmly, and we're good to go. When you first boot up the Dream Track, the matrix LEDs will blink a test sequence. The default program loads. All steps preload to the middle note. This is to help you tune your oscillators to the Dream Track. All octaves will start at zero octave shift as well. All track patterns are forward, and all four tracks start at the first step. You can start by sending a clock source to the clock input. You should see the steps moving forward. Then you can send your clock out to your envelope. You'll hear your voice, but it's not receiving a pitch until you send the CV out to your 1 volt per octave in on your oscillator. You'll notice that all of the clock inputs are multed to the first one. If you don't want to receive a clock, say on track 2, you can just patch in a unused patch cord on that one. And you'll notice it has stopped receiving any kind of a trigger. You can manually step that one by tapping the trigger button for that track. Even though it's not hooked up to anything, you can see that that step is moving around. You can even unplug that one for number 1 and manually step that one through. It will go ahead and send a trigger to your envelope when it does so, even though there's no clock on that input. So you'll notice that the lights have gotten out of sequence. Oh, that's great, because you can change the pattern We're looking at track one. It's going forward. You can do reverse. You can do forward, then reverse. Or you can do what's called zigzag, which steps like that. Just kind of jumps around. You can change the octave for that track by holding down the octave button and changing the data. You can shift it up. You can shift it down. Now when you see those two lights, that means it's in the middle. You can even go two octaves down, way down or way up. Pretty cool. If you go too high and the pitch of the notes are already high, they're gonna be reset back to the lowest note. And just like that, on the low end, it will knock the lowest note. If it goes past the range, it will make it be the highest note. So that can be done for a good effect. You can have it reset to the beginning by hitting the reset button. They're all on different patterns, so if you set them all back to forward, they'll all be marching forward again. And then reset. Let's start programming steps. Let's start programming the pitches for each step. To do that, you press and hold the step program button for that track, and it will freeze. And then you can hear the notes as you change them. Pretty cool. Now, if you like what you have done, you can store it as a program. And then you can even recall. This is a blank program, by the way. Store doesn't remember the octave, and it doesn't remember the patterns either. It can only remember the note pitches. Okay, ahead of time, I went ahead and programmed note pitches for all four of the tracks. And if you've done so like that, you can hit the rotate button and it will move number four up to one, and then shift the others down. So let's see what happens. That I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change my clock input to an LFO that goes up into audio rates. It will keep up with however fast your LFO can go. Just remember, it can do this with four tracks. It can go to four oscillators at the same time. Pretty cool.